do is to push the bobbin adjusting knob. This is a little knob that as the bobbin winds, it senses how full is this bobbin getting. And when it gets to be a certain fullness, it literally pops away and your bobbin stops rotating. You can adjust this actually to have a bobbin wind only half full or all the way full. But we're going to push this in place. Now we're going to reach over to the balance wheel. Remember that balance wheel screw that I told you about before, that clutch? What we're going to do is use our left hand to hold on to the balance wheel. Our right hand moves the clutch screw towards us, about half a turn. Now what we've done is we've literally disengaged the rest of the machine, so only the bobbin will move, not the machine. The machine will be going up and down and up and down.
So at this point, just step on the foot control, wind your bobbin until it's full, and off you go. Now that the bobbin is wound, just lift it off, cut your thread. So here is our wound bobbin, and here is our bobbin case. The way to put the bobbin into the case correctly is that the tab of the bobbin case, right there, you hold up about 12 o'clock. The bobbin itself, you want to hold that so that the thread dangles off the right side of the bobbin. In other words, I don't want it this way. I want it this way. Now just drop the bobbin in place. Right about 3 o'clock, if this is 12, this is 3, your thread has a little bit of a slice. I mean, the bobbin case has a bit of a slice that the thread just finds itself wanting to go to. And then you're going to just slide that thread into place, pull out a couple of inches. It should come out nice and smoothly. And now we're ready to put the bobbin into the machine, into the side here. Now this is a difficult bobbin to put in. If you take this bobbin case tab, you see it opens and closes? If you open it all the way, it keeps your bobbin from falling out as you're trying to put the bobbin in the machine. If you don't pull that tab all the way out, your bobbin will fall out as you're trying to get to the machine. It's real frustrating. So again, if you lay that bobbin back in place, open up this tab all the way. It can't open anymore. Now, put your finger in there. Force your finger in there. Your bobbin won't fall out, and you can put that into the bobbin area. Close the door, and now we'll thread the machine. Now, I played around here a little bit. Let's take the thread out of the bobbin winding tension spring, and let's get ready to thread the machine. Go to the first thread guide. There's one. There's two. Different machines will have different numbers of thread guides. After the thread guides, it's down to the tension. Again, make sure you're not in front of the tension or behind the tension, but in between the two tension plates. Around the tension discs, pull up to catch that check spring, and then go up to the take-up lever. Now you see again, I folded my thread. Go through the take-up lever. Now look for the thread guide. Thread guide and a thread guide. So some machines have more thread guides or less thread guides than this one, but it's always going to be a series of spool pin to thread guides to tension to take up lever and then down to thread guides. That's pretty much the sequence. So you thread this needle on this machine from left to right. Now all of the new machines, the needles thread front to back. It's a whole lot easier than this. That's one of the good things about the new machines today. But this machine, an older machine with a side load, is going to thread with the from left to right. So you need to get your head out there and look this direction. So now let's spend some time with a little bit more modern machine. The first thing I'm going to do is to take off the accessory tray. That's going to give me access to where my bobbin goes. Now, this is a front load bobbin, and it's a free arm, so it makes it quite a bit easier for us. First of all, let's wind a bobbin. Here's my bobbin. Let's find our bobbin winding spindle right here. First, let's put our thread in place. Our thread goes from the spool pin next to the little guide. Now let's locate the bobbin winder tension dial. There it is. And we're going to come from the front all the way around to the back. We're going to create a little X of thread. Now keep that thread coming. Now again, there's two ways to wind a bobbin. There's the way we mostly do it, which is basically wrap it around the bobbin a few times and hope that it takes, or the correct way, which is to take the bobbin and put it through one of these huge holes and put the bobbin in place on the bobbin winding spindle. And in this case, we want to push the bobbin winding spindle to the right. That's going to engage it. Then I'm going to reach to my balance wheel on the side here, hold on to it with my left hand, and turn towards me with my right. So now what I've done is I've disengaged the machine from sewing. Only the bobbin will wind now. So hold the bobbin thread out of the way. Start the winding process. After it's wound just a little bit, cut the thread very close to the bobbin and continue winding. Now as you see this machine winding its bobbin, this area here is my bobbin thread sensor. And when the bobbin gets wound just a little beyond maximum, it'll push the bobbin away and the bobbin will stop winding thread. If I only want a bobbin that's half wound with a particular thread, I can just lift my foot off the machine anytime, push the bobbin winder spindle to the left, cut the thread, and continue on. So I don't have to wind my bobbin full all the time. If I'm mending, I'm using different colors, I can just wind as much as I need. Now, with the bobbin held so that the thread dangles off the right side, do you see what I'm saying here? It's off the right side. And with my bobbin case facing me so that the spindle is up at 12 o'clock, I put the bobbin in the bobbin case. And if this is 12 here, right about 3 o'clock is a little slot in the bobbin case. The thread goes in that slot and you pull into this spring and then take the bobbin thread, pull out a little bit. Make sure that you're not holding onto the bobbin, but your thread should come out very smoothly. It should not be too loose or too tight. Now lean the bobbin back. Don't lean it forward. Lean it back. Here's the bobbin tab. Open that tab all the way with your finger. Now, if this is all the way open, when I do like this, I won't lose my bobbin. If it's not all the way open, my bobbin will fall out. Drives you crazy. So basically, let's get this all the way back, open up the tab all the way, and take that and put that into the machine. And what I want you to do is locate the little tab, the little notch. Locate the little notch. The bobbin tab is going to fit right in the notch and be flush. And the bobbin is in. So let's thread this.